But in the end, it was short-sighted as far as I'm concerned, because you need examples, you need role models. And the company was that for hundreds and hundreds of dance students. And I think it was maybe penny-wise, but very pound-foolish to have closed a large, respected company at that time, besides putting 22 excellent dancers out of work. After the company closed, I had to be very careful with myself because I had put so much of my energy and so much of my artistic, creative energy and effort into the company itself that I had nothing to work from. I went into a severe depression, I would say, and I thought about it while I was in the depression that this is just not going to work. And I can't let the people who didn't understand what we were doing affect me in this way, because then they were winning. And I refused to accept that. So I plunged into painting. And for 3 years, I painted nonstop. I did literally paintings, mostly drawings and pastel work. I stayed a member of the board, but I was assigned to history. And as the treasure house of history is saying, oh, you shouldn't do that because we did it before, that seems to be my job at the board. And I explained that we did this before and we tried that before, because over the 20 some odd years of our existence, we did try everything. One of the things I enjoy doing is teaching choreography. And I have taught quite a few courses, international dance course for professional choreographers and composers. This is always a very exciting, interesting opportunity to not only give what you know to young people, but to get feedback from them and be challenged so that you can increase what you know. I've always used one premise or two premises in teaching, and that's teaching technique or teaching choreography. Teach only what you know. Don't teach what you don't know. And teach with as much love, using that word again, teach with as much love and care as you can. And there is a third thing, and that is teach everything you know. Don't hold something back because that gives you a little power. Teach everything you know. And if you do that, you empty yourself constantly and you find that in return, the dancers or the choreographers give you back an enormous amount of information and you begin to learn more. So you know more. So the next time you come, you can teach more than you taught before because you know more, because you've received that information back. And that exchange is one that I find the most exciting thing about working in dance. I didn't consider myself a passionate choreographer in that I had ideas that I wanted to explore and say. I wasn't going to make social changes through the choreography. I wanted to make dances that dancers could enjoy doing and express themselves with on stage. I felt very strongly that the dancer is the medium through which you express the dance. So I had to work the dancers into the dance through their own bodies, and that was more important to me than the dance itself. And I think the dances that I did existed for the moment. They existed in the performance. If the performance was good, they worked. And that was more important to me than the structure, than even the idea, because the idea was man's personal existence. And that to do that on the stage for a dancer, I thought was just a wonderful experience. And a wonderful experience also for the audience. And that's what I tried to do.
Two steps.
I'm now at a point in my life where I have this beautiful house in the south of France. I'm quite content to just be where I am and doing what I'm doing. And I feel I have worked in the world hard. And that's that. That part of my life is done. And I'm in another place now.